फ्रेंड्स वेलकम टू youtube.com/DrVet चैनल। आई एम डॉक्टर पी आर पटेल, प्रोफेशनल हेड वेटरनरी मेडिसिन। वी आर डीलिंग विथ इम्पॉर्टेंट डिजीज फैटी लिवर सिंड्रोम, द इम्पॉर्टेंट मेटाबॉलिक डिजीज ऑफ काउज एंड बफेलोज। वी ऑलरेडी सीन द इटियोलॉजी, नाउ इन पार्ट टू वील स्टडी पैथोजेनेसिस एंड क्लिनिकल फाइंडिंग्स। पैथोजेनेसिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट टू अंडरस्टैंड द डिजीज एंड टू प्लान द लाइन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट, सो दैट वी कैन गिव प्रॉपर ट्रीटमेंट एंड सेव द लाइफ ऑफ द एनिमल। सो अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ पैथोजेनेसिस इज वेरी मच इंपॉर्टेंट। क्लिनिकल फाइंडिंग्स आर नॉट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक। We discuss now the pathogenesis of fatty liver syndrome. This fatty liver can develop very fast within 24 hours of an animal going off it. Inhibitions and within 24 hours animal develop fatty liver syndrome. Because of the inhibitions, anorexia, negative energy balance. So when there is negative energy balance, there is a mobilization of body fat reserves because animals are already fatty, and this mobilization of fat reserve is triggered by hormonal cues or hormonal indications. Hormonal changes at the parturition and hormonal changes at the initiation of lactation formation, milk formation, that causes mobilization of body fat reserves. The adipose triglyceride is converted to an important chemical, non-esterified fatty acid, NGFA. Now what will happen to NEFA, N-E-F-A, we'll see in the next slide. Continuation of pathogenesis. When the animal goes off it, there is a most dramatic increase of non-esterified fatty acid at the time of calving. Why at the time of calving? Because of the hormonal cues for parturition and lactogenesis. Now this NEFA is taken up by the liver and it is oxidized to ketone bodies that we have already seen in ketosis video, or esterified and transformed to hepatic triglyceride. Remember here, with high glucose availability, there is a favoring of the development of fatty liver syndrome. Against that, with high glucose availability, it will not favor development of the ketosis. That also we have already seen in the ketosis videos. Continuation of the pathogenesis. This increased hepatic NEFA uptake and its esterification, there is accumulation of triglycerides in the liver. The ketone body formation or ketone formation is favored when the blood glucose concentration are low. When the blood glucose concentration are high, the fatty liver syndrome is favored. The conditions that lead to low blood glucose level and insulin concentration, that also contribute to fatty liver, because the insulin suppresses fat mobilization from the adipose tissue. So insulin also play a part for development of fatty liver syndrome. continuation of the pathogenesis, the greatest increase in liver triglyceride occur at carb. The etiology we have seen by at the carb. The excessive accumulation of intracellular triglyceride in liver cells results pathology into the liver. It disturbs the overall liver function and cell damage. Liver is an important organ. So liver function and cell damage causes other disturbance into the body. Friends, remember, don't be under misunderstanding. Fatty liver is not a consequence of positive energy balance or overfeeding. Please introduce this concept in your mind. It is a disease of negative energy balance or inappetence or anorexia. Continuation of the pathogenesis. Triglyceride deposition will occur only if animal become overconditioned. So one condition is overconditioned or overfatting. And consequently reduced feed intake. So these two conditions are the main important condition that is happening at the time of carb. Development of fatty liver syndrome can happen very quickly once it starts. And this fatty liver syndrome very quickly develops within 48 hours under extreme condition of the fat metabolism, fat mobilization. So remember, this disease develops very fast. Once it initiates, within 1 or 2 days of the fat mobilization, quickly fatty liver syndrome develops. Friends, we have understood the etiology. I narrated it on and often. We have learned the pathogenesis. Now we are going to study clinical findings of fatty liver syndrome. Friends, remember, there is no pathognomonic clinical signs that you can provide diagnosis. No characteristic sign. No specific signs. But certain vague signs are there. Depression, anorexia, decreased rumen motility, ketosis and ketonuria. Mostly ketosis and ketonuria accompany this fatty liver syndrome. Don't forget that. In the video on ketosis also, we have studied that also. That fatty liver syndrome mostly accompanies ketosis. We continue with the clinical findings. We observe the signs of liver dysfunction or liver inefficiency. We also the signs of the ketosis. So some cow may show a signs of ketosis. And you know that nervous form of ketosis and its sign. Some cow become aggressive, restlessness. Some cow excited, ataxia, staggering gait or incoordination of movement. There is a stargazing posture. The head is raised, stretched, and animal looks at the sky. So it is called as stargazing posture. Head is raised up and the animal assumes a posture that animal observes the star. That is because of muscular tremors of head and neck that keep the head up. And another important thing is that animal may not respond to ketosis treatment, because this is not only the ketosis, but along with ketosis there is fatty liver syndrome. So it requires the treatment of both. We continue with the clinical findings. Reduction of the milk production. There is constipation because the liver is affected. The feces is hard, firm, and very scanty because the liver bile has a laxative effect. Now liver is affected, so there is constipation, indigestion. There is great weakness because animal is constantly anorexic, not taking food, inappetence. There is great weight loss because of the anorexia also. Because of anorexia weakness, the animal sits down, sternal recumbency. Then animal progress to a terminal stage, polypnea. Animal is too weak, showing the expiratory grunt. There is tachycardia. The muzzle is dry and muzzle shows accumulation of flakes containing epithelium on the muzzle. Continuation of the clinical findings of fatty liver syndrome. If the animal is not treated properly or timely, animal progresses to a fatal condition. There is thermally fetid yellow diarrhea. Animal slowly progresses to coma and death of the animals in 10 to 15 days. So here we have seen two groups of symptoms, and both groups are mostly combined accordingly. The symptoms are vague, symptoms of liver dysfunction and symptoms of ketosis. We know that this fatty liver syndrome is also occurring due to concurrent diseases at the time of parturition or periparturition. So fatty liver syndrome symptoms are accompanying with the concurrent disease symptoms such as metritis, retained fetal membranes, mastitis, parturient paresis, displaced abomasum, and other disease. Whatever disease is present, it also shows its symptoms. Continuation of the pathogenesis. This increased hepatic NAPA uptake and its esterification, there is accumulation of triglycerides in the liver. The ketone body formation or ketone formation is favored when the blood glucose concentration are low. When the blood glucose concentration are high, the fatty liver syndrome is favored. The conditions that lead to low blood glucose level